The first movement of the suite may be the most challenging thing to listen to yet. There's some very intense moments, but they will be contrasted by the beauty of the second movement and then the raw power and energy of the third movement. You can listen for how I believe Duraflay very effectively and differently uses the tritone. In the first movement, it's used to create a lot of harmonic tension, whereas in the second movement, especially in the contrasting sections of the rondo form, it is used as an expressive device, and it's very beautiful. So it's very interesting to me that Duraflay really couldn't stand the toccata that he wrote at this suite. As a teacher, he refused to let students play it for him, and he just really, really didn't like it. There's a little bit of a parallel with Vidor and his toccata from the Fifth Symphony, although there I don't think Vidor despised the piece so much as he simply wished people would play it a little bit slower. But it does make one wonder if, like, Paco Bell got sick of his canon or Bach grew tired of Jesu Joy. Well, we don't know these things. But not being a composer, it's just interesting to me that someone would come up with something that the rest of us feel is just really, really great and appreciate, and has become one of the most well-known pieces in organ repertoire, but he himself just did not care for it. So we have the suite.